Hi, this is part 5 in loops in C#.NET. In this video, we'll discuss about how to write a program to reverse a given number, and we'll write a program to check whether the given number is palindrome or not. Right? So here initially, I will declare one number, something like 1234. I want to reverse the given 4-digit number. So once when you reverse, you will get the number like 4321. So here if you observe clearly, initially 4 is in units place, 3 is in tens place, 2 is in hundreds place, 1 is in thousands place. Right. So once I want to send this 4 to which place? Tens place. Next I want to move the 4 to hundreds place. Next to thousands place. So I want to rotate the loop for 4 times because 4 digits are there. So I will write the for loop. For int I is equals to 1. I less than equals to 4, I plus plus. Is it clear? This is my for loop. Now initially I will take one variable for remainder, int r is equals to 0, and I will take one more variable for reverse number to store the output. Int reverse number is initially 0. Now as we already discussed in the last video that if you want to identify the units place number, you have to use what? Number modulus 10. Number modulus 10 is used to get the units place number. Modulus operator is used to identify the units place number, and by operator is used to separate the units place number. It is used to remove the identified number. Now here I will write some logic like reverse number is equals to reverse number into 10. Initially reverse number is 0, I will multiply with what? 10. And then I will add this reverse number into 10 to remainder. Here the remainder is R. Right, this is the logic for your program to reverse the given number. So here I want to print the statement console.writeln of reverse number. Let us check how this one will execute. So here you can check, initially I declared one variable for number and one variable for remainder r and one variable for reverse number. So this is number and this is r to store the remainder and this is reverse number. So initially number is 1234. Remainder is 0 and reverse number is also 0. Now here you can see, and I will take one more variable for I. So initial I is 1, means what? First time we are rotating the loop. So here number modulus 10, number is how much? 1234 modulus 10. So the remainder is 4. Is it clear? So here R is how much? 4. Now here you can see initial reverse number is 0. 0 into 10 is 0. 0 plus 4. So reverse number is how much? 4. Now number is equal to number by 10. Number is 1234 by 10. We will get what? 123. Because by will give us what? Quotient. Modulus will give us remainder. So 123. Now I is how much? 2. Means what? Second time we are rotating the loop to get the unit space number. So now the number is how much? 123. So here 123 modulus 10, so you will get 12, sorry, remainder. Remainder is how much? 3. So here R is how much? 3. Is it clear? So reverse number is 4. 4 into 10 means 40. 40 plus 3. I am multiplying the reverse number with what? 10. So you get 43. Means what? Your 4 went to tens place. Number is 123. 123 by 10. You will get what? 12. So here you can say. Now the number is how much? 12. Right. I is how much? 3. Means what? Third time we are rotating the loop. So number is 12. So here you can say 12 modulus 10. 12 modulus 10. Remainder is how much? 2. So here R is how much? 2. Right. Reverse number is 43. 43 into 10. 430. 430 plus 2, how much? 432. Is it clear? Now if you observe, your number went to hundreds place. Now number is how much? 12. 12 by 10 is how much? 1. So here the number is 1. Right. So here I is how much? 4. Means what? Fourth time we are rotating the loop. Right. Now the number is 1. So here I will write 1 modulus 10. 1 modulus 10. The remainder is how much? 1. So here R is how much? 1. Right, reverse number is 432. 432 into 10. 4320. 4320 plus 1. 4321. Now number is how much? 1. 1 by 10 is how much? 0. So number is how much here? 0. Right. I is how much? 5. Means what? Fifth time I am trying to rotate the loop. 5 less than equals to 4. Condition is what? False. Come out of the loop and print what? A reverse number. Let us check this program. So here you can say, I will execute the program. 4321. For example, if you give another number, 7234. Here you can say, 4327, reverse number. This number will work only for what? 4 digit number. But if you want to work for any type of number, instead of for loop, you can go for what? While loop. Is it clear? So here what I will do means, I will declare something like console.println of enter a number. I will read the number from where? Console. So int number is equals to, here you can write int dot parse of console dot read line. I want to read the input from where? Console. And now here instead of for loop, I will use which loop? While loop. While number not equals 0. It means that when the number will become 0 means your number is reversed. So while loop is condition based loop, for loop is range based loop. If you know the range, go for loop. If you don't know the range, go for while loop. So it will work for any type of number. You give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The reverse number is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Similarly, you give 154. The reverse number is 451. I hope you understood. So here let us see the flow of execution so that you will get some clarity here. So initially I will take one variable for number, one variable for remainder r, one variable for reverse number, that's it. So this is for number and this is for r and this is for reverse number. So initially number is how much? Let us assume the number is 1123, let us assume. I enter the number. So initial r is how much? 0. Reverse number is how much? 0. Now check here. 123 not equals to 0. Condition is what? True. So it will go and it will take number modulus 10. So you will get what? R means how much? 3. So reverse number is initially 0. 0 into 10. 0 plus 3. So reverse number is how much? 3. Is it clear? So number is 123 by 2. 1 by 10 you will get what? 12. 12 is the number. Now again rotate the loop. 12 not equals 0. Condition is true. Again find the remainder. So what is 12 modulus 10? You will get what? 1. Is it clear? I think 2, sorry. You will get 2 here. 12 modulus 10 is 2. Now R is 2. So reverse number 3. 3 into 10. 30 plus 2. So you will get what? 32 is the reverse number. Right? So number is equal to number by 10. Number by 10 means 12 by 10 you will get what? 1. Right? So 1 not equals 0. Condition is true. Number is 1. 1 modulus 10. You will get, if the numerator is less than denominator, then the quotient is 0 and remainder is what? Numerator. So R is 1. Reverse number is 32. 32 into 10, 320. 320 plus 1. Here you can say reverse number is 321. Now number is how much? 1 by 10. You will get what? 0. Now check the condition again. 0 not equals 0. Condition is false. Come out, print what? Reverse number. Reverse number is 321. I hope you understood. So now I want to write a program to check whether the given number is palindrome or not. So first of all you must know what is palindrome. Palindrome means given number is equals to reverse number. Then that number is called as palindrome. If the given number is equals to reverse number, then that number is called as palindrome. So here you can say, you can write even with while loop you can write, or even you can write with for loop. So here I will write, I will declare one more variable and int temp, temp is equals to what? Number, I will store the number in the temporary variable and finally I will write if, I will check the condition, if number, if temp is equals to reverse number, if temp is equals to reverse number then I want to print palindrome, else not a palindrome. This program will work for any type of number. For example, if I give 1564, it is not a palindrome. And if I give something like 151, reverse it, you will get 151, it is a palindrome. Similarly, if you give 1001, reverse it, you will get the same number. So it is a palindrome. If you want to write with for loop, so with the help of while loop you can write the program for any type of input, this program will work. But for loop will work only with a specific input. Let us see here. For example, I want to write the program with for loop. So here I will declare one number. Int number is equals to something like 151. So I will declare one variable. Int r is equals to 0. I will declare one more variable. Int reverse number is equals to initially 0. I want to rotate the loop for 3 times because I want to identify 3 numbers are there. So here I use equals to 1, I less than equals to what? 3, I plus plus. Now here I will write r is equals to number modulus 10. Is it clear? Number is equals to number by 10. Right. So here I want to find the reverse number. Reverse number is equals to reverse number into 10 plus r. That is the logic. Right. Same, just I am changing the loop. And here you can see if here I will declare one more variable called temp. Int temp is equals to what? Number. So here I will write the logic. If temp double equals to what? A reverse number, then I want to print palindrome. Is it clear? Else I want to print not a palindrome. I hope you understood. Here you see it is a palindrome. If you give any other number, 153, you will get not a palindrome. If you want, you can give the input values and check whether it is working or not. I hope you understood. In this video, we discussed about to check whether the given number is palindrome or not. In the next video, I will discuss about how to check whether the given string is palindrome or not. For more videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and Facebook group. Thank you. Have a nice day.